Life is all about how we see the world. Perspective. Is the proverbial glass half full or half empty? How we perceive the world affects our actions, our thoughts, and our very lives. And especially for the generation that suffered the horrors of the Holocaust, perspective is everything.
I think my family has a unique perspective on life. I don't think many people know that my grandfather, Sam Menlo, was a survivor of the camps. He suffered greatly, and he had a lot of loss in his family, and there was a lot of tragedy for him.
Coming to America and, you know, having a whole other life, I think that my grandfather really, fear wasn't something which was an option. It was like, you know, let's get a crew together, let's build something. I'm not afraid of financial risk or being a failure or anything like that. It was just like very determined. He was very determined, very motivated, and there was no stopping him.
After what my grandfather endured in the war, he was determined to rebuild and make sure that Yiddishkeit flourished in Los Angeles.
He had a vision, he had a goal, and I think he had every intention of building up a family and passing that down to his family, whether it be, you know, integrity and honesty in business. He is a very staunch supporter of the Torah world in general, whether it be kollels or schools. We have a fairly large family. There are, I don't know exactly, but, you know, over 30 grandchildren. And, you know, they can be found in all parts of the world, learning, working. They do try and carry on that tradition and that legacy. And I also aspire to be like my grandfather and my father.
And who's the son?
You.
The son?
Me.
And who's the daddy?
You.
My name is Avi Heyman. I married Tanya Menlo, so I married into the Menlo family. And I always like to say that Valley Torah was the best thing that ever happened to me. A lot of people who may be sitting in the audience here tonight know me very well to be a boy with a lot of energy. And a boy with a lot of energy can use it for the good or use it for the bad. And coming to Valley Torah, they really knew how to help me channel that energy into something good.
The process to answer the question. So that's what it says over here. So now, plug it in over here, please.
This used to be my locker right here.
So for a ice cold can of Diet Pepsi, the proximity of Tzitzis Shabbos tells you that even though your Tzitzis might be made out of Shabbos, what do you do?
One of the things that Valley Torah does so well is find the individual talents of every student. I wanted to be more active in high school, so Mrs. Grossman allowed me to, once I got my driver's license, to pick up, you know, lecturers and, you know, pick people up from the airport. They put me to work on chesed activities. They helped me feel that I was contributing in my own way.
Being that I had all the energy that I had, and I loved playing sports, but I just couldn't make the team, Valley Torah allowed me to raise funds for a mascot costume, and I actually became the Wolfpack for Valley Torah. I was the mascot on the basketball courts by every Valley Torah game. After I graduated from Valley Torah, Rabbi Strix called me one day and said, look, we wanted to make a virtual newsletter. Would you like to anchor the video? I said, sure, no problem.
Hey, and thank you for coming back to Valley Torah's second monthly news video. Let us begin with a very special event at the girls' high school.
I was raised in New York. I married Yonatan about a year and a half ago. Some of my friends have not had good experiences in their schools, and I'm grateful. My husband is happy, and he loves his Yiddishkeit, and this is all because he had a good place to go for high school.
I became close with Rabbi Strix during my years at Valley Torah. I spent many Shabbosim by him with his family, and I really think I learned a lot about family values and being a part of community, doing chesed, while spending time with him, with his family. I believe I was the beneficiary of his generosity.
Our connection with Valley Torah didn't end after graduation. Valley Torah helped guide me to the seminary that was appropriate for me, and it was almost like an extension of Valley Torah, this seminary that I went to. I felt a lot of love and a lot of, you know, one-on-one, and that's what I needed.
We were very grateful and lucky to have Rabbi Stuberger as our matchmaker. Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match.
I think Rabbi Stuberger had a hunch about Avi and I, and he really pushed for us to start dating. I'm really appreciative to that, and to the Jewish home that we're building together, and it's because of him.
There is a real sense of achdus at Valley Torah between the teachers and the students, and especially between the students themselves. The teachers in the Rebbeim at Valley Torah, they really give it their all.
Valley Torah has an excellent arts program, and they have great extracurricular activities, and it really shows in the students.
You know, there are a lot of people, especially here in the city, that don't realize that Torah Judaism does exist past Melrose. Tzedakah starts at home, and the Valley is part of our tzibur.
Valley Torah deserves a lot of credit for not abandoning viable students in these challenging economic times.
I know for a fact that if this school feels that you are the right student for the school, they will do what it takes to make sure you get into this school.
In different schools, and they say, oh, I wish I could have, you know, a Rebbe that does that or someone to look up to like that. And it's really, it's exceptional to remain here.
It's a great experience. I was in Rabbi Stuberger's office every single day.
Right. So what did Valley Torah do to help you get in?
It helped everything.
Everything. It's awesome. You want to stay here?
Yeah.
The economic situation that we're in today is serious and it's real, but it is not in any way comparable to what it was, you know, in the Holocaust and pogroms and the ghettos.
We really need to help Valley Torah, especially in these tumultuous times, and not abandon them, just like they have never abandoned any of the students.
All of us know that there are many from families out there, all because of Valley Torah. And if we were to give up in these tough times like today, I mean, what does it say about our commitment? And what does it say about our perspective?
My perspective is that Valley Torah really benefited me. It helped infuse my life with Yiddishkeit and individuality.
My perspective is that I'm happy that I can finally become part of this Valley Torah community.
I have perspective. I know what's important, and Valley Torah is a priority.
Menlo Boys Division, Menlo Girls Division, Valley Torah High School.
They're the school that cares.